So in recent times, after a long period of research and observation, I've taken my time to study what is actually the problem in Nigeria and where Nigeria is missing out. Since after the 90s, the tenure of our past president, Goodluck Jonathan, when the economy of Nigeria began to cripple, right? And I will not dispute the fact that Nigeria has never been great. Nigeria has been great after the independence up till late, when the present's current leaders took it upon themselves to make it a habit of embezzling and disrupting the growth, the progress, and the success of the country. So this is the major reason and idea behind this motive of this video, because at the end of the day, whether you like it or not, you will definitely want to check the level of your progress by comparing yourself with the next person to see how well and how far you are doing. And as a country, there are so many West African countries, there are so many African countries that we as Nigerians should time to time be checking ourselves with to be sure that we are doing well or we are progressing. Because currently, I see so many people come out to say, don't compare Nigeria to other countries, don't compare Nigeria, Nigeria is this, Nigeria is that. We are not disputing the fact that there are no good things happening in Nigeria as much as there are bad things. There are no good people in Nigeria as much as there are bad people. There is always the negative and the positive. And how do you do better and outweigh the negative is by changing the things that are not well, that are not okay in the country. Starting from us as citizens down to our leaders, right? Now, if I want to liken what I have come to, you know, understand about the country Ghana, why they are succeeding, why they have grown so much over the years after their independence, from the period they went through their own crisis up till date, I actually came to realize that there are so many things, so many factors that they incorporated in their system within them that has helped them, shaping them, and brought them to where they are today. And that is what I feel we Nigerians should be doing, instead of bashing and fighting ourselves, trying to shut ourselves up because we are coming out to talk. And let me tell you, before you say Nigerians should not speak out or speak up, remember we have the TV stations, we have the news channels, we have the radio stations. These are places where news that happens in Nigeria and other parts of West African countries are being conveyed out. And there are people who watch and listen to all these things. So why don't you go there and tell them to shut the channels up, right? Even in other African or West African countries, there are things that go wrong there too, that their news and press stations and media carry out. So let me put your head and your mind in order to know that it is not a crime, but your right as a human being, as a citizen of whatever country you are watching and listening to me, to demand for your citizenship rights as a citizen from your leaders. When things are not going on well, you have that right in a democratic system of government to ask your leaders to do better, to pinpoint things and areas where they are not doing better, so that they will hear. It is just that we have a failed and a very evil and cruel leaders that when you tend to talk, when you tend to correct, when you tend to pinpoint them, they look for a way to silence you, to eliminate you, so that you will not exist on the surface of the earth to try to correct or stop them from doing the evil and the bad things that they are doing. From time to time, I will always come out here on this platform and dedicate this platform to talk and address things that are not going and sitting well in the country, as much as things that are happening right as well, so that you don't say I'm always on the negative. If I see the good things, I will talk. If I see the negative ones, I will talk. If I see what Nigeria is doing well, I will commend it, right? So that it won't look as though I'm biased, right? Now, and to add to that, I will be solely dedicating most of my videos on these topics, because I see that there are so many channels that are supposed to be using their voices, that are capable, that have the large audience, that has the voice, but rather what do we see? They use their voices in talking about other people's life, other people's business. Fine, I'm not here to tell you what to do on your channel, but I think time to time we as Nigerians need to be addressing things that are not sitting well in the country, that are not working well in the country, so that the more we raise our voices, the better for us. Now, when you look at the Ghanaian government, you will see that one thing that has kept them going and, you know, brought them to where they are is what? Collective and relative peace and unity. Humility as well, between them, amongst them, and their leaders as well. You cannot underestimate, you cannot undermine the love, the unity, the peace they have amongst themselves. And that's why they are doing amazingly well. They are doing great. I am not saying they are 100% perfect. Although they have their struggles, but you see that when they talk, their leaders listen and act on it. Their leaders too have positive mindset. But can that actually be in Nigeria? Do Nigerian leaders listen? Things happen on daily basis. Children are being kidnapped from schools in the northern part of the country, in some other part of the state. But yet, they pay little to no attention in how to put a stop to it and make sure that these things don't constantly reoccur. But you see, in Ghana, once something happens, just like we see in the current incident that is going on now, where a Nigerian and a Ghanaian are being missing for over a month now, and our Nigerian government are not even acting as though something wrong has happened. But look at the Ghanaian government. They have put it to Nigerian government to make sure that their citizen who came into Nigeria be found and brought back alive. Can Nigerians do this for their citizens? How many of our citizens are outside the country that are being killed on daily basis, that are being molested, that are being brutalized in other people's country, and Nigeria will keep mute? How many of our citizens are serving jail terms and prison terms for crimes that they do not commit? I'm not talking about people who go out to other people's country to commit crime, because when you go out to other people's country to misbehave and commit any crime, you will go in for it. You will face the law, so that you will know that it is not in Nigeria that you come and do anyhow and go scot-free. You will know that if you are in another man's country, you need to be of the best behavior, comply to their country's rules and regulations. Abide to the rules and regulations of any country you find yourself. Why is it that most of you, when you leave Nigeria, once you step into another country, your brain automatically resets? Most times, and some of you too, your brain doesn't reset. You still carry that Nigerian mentality and attitude and start displaying there. What happens to you? You will be severely dealt with. This rubbish you people do anyhow in Nigeria. Most of you, when you travel out there, you behave like people that their brain was flashed and reset back to factory setting. Then when you come back to Nigeria, you want to behave anyhow because you see that Nigeria is a lawless place. Anybody can do anyhow and go scot-free. Is that what you're trying to tell me? Can that actually be in Ghana, in South Africa, in Kenya, and other countries? When you look at it on the aspect of the educational system, what do you see? The educational system in Ghana is highly respected and valued, is maintained, is updated and well-structured, and well regulated as well. Now let me tell you, when it comes to Nigeria educational system, we have the government and the private sector as well, just like we have in Ghana. But look at how the private sector is taking so much lead compared to the government sector, because Nigeria has created that loophole to the citizens to take advantage of that. You see that if you want to have a quality education in Nigeria, you must have the money to go to the best private school. Now look at the university sector. You see that the school fees there is one thing that is, you know, on its own, pricing is exorbitant or average, but at the end of the day, what comes with that school fees when it comes to lecturers frustrating students, the sorting, you know, the molestation and abuse of male lecturers to female students, frustrating them by failing their courses so that these children will continue to repeat the course that they sat down, read and wrote the exams and passed because they want money or they want to abuse them sexually. Now look at the incident. Let me retrace it back to the incident that happened in one of the Nigerian universities where the student was frustrated and committed suicide and passed. She unalived herself and the mom had to bring the body to the school to come and eat up, mentioning the name of the lecturer. Did we not see it? You will tell me that I should not talk, and we see all these things coming up on the social media where the whole world is watching. Please, it's high time you use your senses very well as a Nigerian. Channel your energy to the right source and lay your complaints and your problem and your frustration to your leaders and be an example, a very good example at that. Let's start with you as a Nigerian. Look at the educational system. The schools that were built by past leaders, past governors, are not being maintained. When there's no maintenance culture, what happens? Everything will tend to dilapidate. Everything will tend to spoil. This leader comes in, will not continue from where the past leader stopped. He will pick a new project and begin from there. Unfinished. Sometimes when it's finished, they leave it. No maintenance culture. It goes down the drain. Wasting the country's money. The money that these people are wasting. I'm telling you, if it's being impacted in the life of the poor masses, the citizens, I think the poverty in Nigeria will be highly elevated. Do we want to talk about the medical and healthcare sector? Can you compare it? The ones that are majorly working here in Nigeria are some of the private hospitals owned by Nigerian doctors. Most of them don't even serve in the government hospital alone. They privatize most of their skills and their knowledge by themselves, for themselves, make it exorbitant. When you go to the government hospital, they refer you to their private hospital where they know that they will rip you off your money. Then the government hospital is subsidized, that is supposed to be working. They frustrate the effort there so that at the end of the day, you'll be left with no option than to go back to their private hospitals. and they will charge you heavily for that. Look at the government hospitals. Look at the government hospitals and other hospitals in Ghana, in Kenya, in South Africa, and every other country. Look at how it's working. Go to the government hospital and go and see how people are dying like chickens every day. Maybe you've not had an encounter, and I pray you don't have that encounter where you will be hospitalized in any government hospital in Nigeria, and Nigeria happens to you, then you will know what you are talking before you open your mouth to talk. I have had my own share in nursing somebody, a sick person in the government hospital. I know what my eyes saw. So when I talk out of experience. I don't talk because I just want to talk. Let us look at the police service system in Ghana and the police force in Nigeria. It's called Nigerian Police Force and Ghana Police Service, showing that Ghana Police Service are serving the citizens, not forcing and enforcing and killing the citizens, just as we see here in Nigeria. They are so corrupt with bribe. They are so corrupt and engulfed with bribe. These are the people that drink alcohol, take substances. I see, not them say, on uniform, and when they are high, you see them acting and behaving in and anyhow. Did you not see the video, the viral video of the policeman? Let me tell you now, that was trying to strangle a driver on motion. Did we not all see it on the media? Did we not all see it, both as Africans, both as West Africans? Is the whole world not watching? Nigerian police. Which one do we talk about them? Which one do we leave? I know that there are good police, Nigerian policemen that are, you know, upright and just in the job that they do. Just few of them. If they are 100, you have 30%. The remaining 70% are nothing to write home about. They are elevated criminals. I'm sorry to say this, but that's the truth. We need to be spelling things the way they are. And you will say, don't talk about Nigeria. You are bringing bad reputation of Nigeria. Other countries, the other countries. Are you people not supposed to be hiding your face in shame? Is there anything that is false or strange? You can cover it for all I care. Igbo people will say, "Oh, well, bearing shame may be key." The more you continue to hide that small poop in your anus, it smells. The better you clean it up, the better for you. Right? The police force in Nigeria, liken it to Ghana. I've heard stories, good stories, impressive stories of how things are working well in the police sector. You have problem, you go there. They attend to your problem without taking a dime from you and make sure that problem is resolved. But go to the police station to report a case. You must start by paying charges first for report. Not less than 5,000, 5,000 naira, as the case may be. You will pay because you want to report a case. Somebody does something wrong to you. You must use money to tell the police what you want to tell them in Nigeria here. And if you're not paying that money, you get out. With something that's supposed to be free according to the law. Which one are we going to talk about? When the police who are supposed to be fishing all these Yahoo Yahoo boys will be collecting money from them and be shutting up because they want to collect their own quota, their own share. And giving these boys the more opportunity and privilege to ride on with what they are doing. Giving kidnappers the privilege and the opportunity to continue in their crime and evil because they are collecting their own share as bribe from them. What are we talking of here? There's nothing I'm going to say here that will completely change everything, but at least it will send a message across, because even the Bible encourages that we should speak out and bear true witnesses and not false witnesses when it comes to issues and things that are wrong. Because the moment you bear false witness, you cover evil, you cover sin, what happens? It will pile up, it will compound, then at the end of the day, it will explode. And when it explodes, what happens? That thing that we are hiding will now come out to the open. I talked about the economic system in Nigeria in my last video. If you've not seen that video, I will link it after this one. Go and watch it. Can you liken the economy system in Nigeria currently to that of Ghana? At least we have some of our Nigerians that are living in Ghana. They can attest to that. And if you're a Nigerian living in Ghana, you have your own share and your own experience, kindly leave it in the comment section. Let it not be as though maybe they will say, "I'm a Nigerian living in Ghana." And what if I'm a Nigerian living in Ghana? Or what if I'm a Nigerian that wants to relocate to Ghana? Are you the one to tell me where to stay? Find out from the Nigerians living in Ghana, in South Africa, in the UK, in London, in every part of the world, how the system is working there, and liken it to that of Nigeria. Everything is well planned and systemized. In the security sector in Ghana, I learned that there is camera that watches and regulates what is happening in the country. That's why when a crime is being committed there, they can easily fish out where that thing happened and how it happened because of the camera. People's children, we have the Chibok girls, we have constantly people's children being kidnapped in different parts of the states, in the country, and no information on how these people will be rescued, how they will be saved, and how they will be secured. is there any camera in Nigeria as a country that monitors what happens, that if something happens or if a crime happens, they can go and find out the environment, the area, and get a camera record, just like we have in other countries, in America, in UK, in Canada. Leave Ghana first, in Canada. And this is where our people are running to. You see all those things and you don't learn. It is high time we stop this rubbish. It is high time we open our eyes and begin to speak out. So with this, I will say, of a truth, Ghana is doing very, very well compared to what Nigerian system presently is experiencing. And Nigeria needs to wake up and learn. If you don't want to learn, if you don't want to change, good for you. Remain where you are. As for me, I will not stop talking and I will not stop, you know, pointing out these things so that our leaders and every person in question, in position, will be aware and, you know, do something positive to change things in this country. So at this point, I believe we have been able to touch, you know, most of the things that we can liken to other countries that are not working in Nigeria. If you know any of them as a Nigerian, or if you know how the system works for you in your country as a Ghanaian, as a Kenyan, wherever you're watching me from, please leave them in the comment section and let this conversation continue from there. And if you've watched up till now, thank you so much for watching. If you're seeing this space for the first time, hi, I'm Chibik Inspirations. And here in Chibik Inspirations, we say it as it is, without minding whose thoughts it's got, to motivate, inspire, not just your spirit, but your soul and your body. Remember to always stay happy, safe, and blessed out there till I come up here on this space. But for now, this is me, Chibik Inspirations, signing out. Bye, guys.